Thank you. Do they exist? Are they real? The evidence is overwhelming that they are here. And we all know they're here. The government knows they're here. All the governments know they're here.
The orbs are many different things. They're non-physical beings. They're coming from a higher dimension than we are. When we die, we leave the body. We move up through the spine. We come on out. We blast on out as a light sphere. And we become an orb. So some of these orbs are discarnate beings. Some orbs are ultra-dimensional beings coming from a much higher frequency. Some of the orbs are nature spirits.
A brilliant light. And then they start stepping their frequencies down. And you can see it becoming more and more physical. And in the end, it looks organic. The greatest UFO we're ever going to experience on the planet is our own physical bodies. And when we can increase our frequencies, we can actually move out of these bodies and experience all of these other planes and dimensions. We have that capability within us. They say there are ships that are physical. There are ships that are pure energy. There are ships that are magnetized light ships. There are ships that are pure consciousness.
These are beings of light who are coming into our world to bring new knowledge to us about how we ourselves become these sacred or divine beings.
Are these beings, William, dimensional, or are they from this universe? Are they angelic? What might they be?
Those are very good descriptions because they're thought of as interdimensional beings, as hyperdimensional beings. They're thought of as thought beings. They are what we think of, at least the early Christian author Origen thought of them as angels and thought that they were made of a supramental type substance that is closer than our physical bodies to the original substance of creation.
Light beings, extraterrestrials coming down in craft, landing in what we now believe to be Atlantis.
A lot of these experiences that I've had have helped me to understand the true nature of man, which is, in truth, a multidimensional being existing on a vibrational continuum. And as we said before, there were low-level contacts in the past, but now it's evolving to a much higher-level contact, you might say, and the benevolent and spiritually and technologically advanced beings are coming in now.
It is not up to extraterrestrials to lower their frequency to reach our state. It is all to do with us raising our frequencies to where they are.
The bliss and the love and the joy is just overwhelming.
But the fact of the matter is, joy comes from that bliss of connectedness. That's our God spirit.
Our true divinity is in our ability to create, and armed with the understanding of the symbiotic connections of life, while being guided by the emergent nature of reality, there is nothing we cannot do or accomplish.
They call it God, they say he has rules, and I think it's cruel. I think you can do it absent religion.
For such false apostles are deceitful workers, and transform themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing, though his ministers transform themselves as though they were ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works.
Once you receive the light, your life will not be the same. You will wake up and then you look at the world and the world will look very different. You look at the body will look very different. Your intelligence will be very different. All because, not because we have gone and gotten some knowledge from schools or college that is very important or picked up some skills. It is not human. It is divine.
I know we are a man-centered people and we think it's all about us, but we are wrong. I love what the old Dutch Reformed theologian Abraham Kuyper used to say. Facing the humanism and the man-centered religion that was so prevalent even in his day, he stood before a group of men and he said this, "I want you men to know what Jesus Christ is going to do when he comes back. He is going to stretch forth his hand and grasp everything that is, and he's going to say, 'Mine, mine, 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 mine. It's all mine. It's always been mine. It was created for me, for my glory, and for my good pleasure. And the only ones that are going to enter into the heavens are the ones that have realized that from the start.'"
Then spoke Jesus again unto them, saying, "I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all." Then Jesus said unto them, "Yet a little while is the light with you. Walk while you have the light, lest darkness come upon you, for he that walketh in darkness knoweth not where he go." Jesus answered, "Are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumble not, because he seeth the light of this world. But if a man walk in the night, he stumbleth, because there is no light in him." For centuries, Satan has tried to transform himself as the light of the world, but there can be only one light, Jesus Christ, for in him can all be saved. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of the darkness, hath shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ.